Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel Online Study Anywhere Anytime. In this video, we will discuss about joint seam stone masonry. In order to secure the stones firmly with each other, the following 9 joints are provided. First one is butt or square joint. Second one is riveted or lap joint. Third one is tongue and groove joint. Fourth one is table joint. Fifth one is saddle or outer joint. Sixth one is rusticated joint. Seventh one is plug joint. Eighth one is dovel joint. And ninth one is cram joint. Now we will see one by one in detail. First type of joint is butt or square joint. In this type of joint, the square surface of one stone is placed against that of another as shown in figure. So in this figure we can see here, the square surface of one stone is placed against that of the another. This is the most common joint and is extensively used for ordinary work. Second type of joint is riveted or lap joint. The rivets are provided which prevent the movement of stones. The two such forms of rivets are shown in figure. So in this figure we can see these two forms of rivets which are provided to prevent the movements of stones. The length of the rivet depends on the nature of the work, but it should not be less than 70 mm. The joint is used for arch work, coping on gables, etc. Third type of joint is tongue and groove joint. In this type of joint, a projection is kept on one stone and a corresponding sinking is provided in the other stone as shown in figure. So in this figure we can see here, in this stone projection is provided and this another stone sinking is provided. This arrangement prevents the sliding of one stone over the other. In this image we can see here, projecting part is called as groove and sinking part is called as tongue. This type of joint is also called as a joggle joint and is rarely used as it involves a great deal of labor and thus becomes expensive. For the end portions of ashlar masonry, the mortar joggle joints are sometimes provided. The cement grout is poured in the joggle formed by means of a hammer and a punch. Fourth type of joint is table joint. In this type of joint, a joggle is formed in the bed of the stone to prevent lateral movement. So in this figure we can see here, joggle is formed in the bed of stone. This is the projection and the depth of projection is about 40 mm and the width of projection is about 1/3 the breadth of the stone. This type of joint is used in the case of structures such as seawalls where the lateral pressure is heavy. Fifth type is saddle or outer joint. The stone is rounded off as shown in figure. If you can see here, this is the plan of saddle joint and here stone is rounded off. If you can see this elevation of saddle joint, here cornice is provided and here we can see here saddle joint. So this type of joint is provided to protect the joints of the cornices and such other weathered surfaces. With the help of this arrangement, any water moving on the weathered surface is diverted from the joints. So it is called as water joint. The saddle is generally beveled backwards from the front edge so as to make it inconspicuous. Sixth type of joint is rusticated joint. In this type of joint, sometimes the margins or edges of stones used for plinth, quoins, outer walls of lower storage, etc., are sunk below the general level. The term rusticated is used to indicate such masonry. The three forms of rusticated joints are shown in figure. First one is V joint, second one is channel joint, and this is the third one, V and channel joint. The channel joint is more common. In this joint, the sinking is made on the lower joint so as to avoid the possibility entry of water through the mortar joint. Seven type is plug joint. In this type of joint, the dovetail shaped mortises are provided in the sides of adjacent stones as shown in figure. So in this figure we can see here dovetail shaped mortises are provided. When stones are placed in position, the molten lead is powered in the joint, which when cooled connects the stones firmly. The cement grout is sometimes used in the place of the molten lead. The joint is used for copings, cornices, etc. Eighth type is dovel joint. A hole is cut into each stone and loose dovels, which are small pieces of hard stone, slate, gunmetal, brass, bronze or copper, are inserted and secured with the cement as shown in figure. So we can see here this is the dovel and this one is the dovel joint. The dovel joint can be easily used in place of joggle joints. The dovel joint, when adopted for columns, is known as bed plug. The dovels are generally 25 mm thick and 100 mm to 150 mm long. This joint also ensures stability of the stones against the displacement. Next type is cramp joint. In this type of joint, the cramps are used instead of dovels. So here we can see here cramps are used instead of dovels. The cramps are the pieces of non-corrosive metals such as gunmetal, copper, etc. and their ends are turned down to a depth of about 40 mm to 50 mm. The length of cramp vary from 200 mm to 300 mm. Width of cramp vary from 25 mm to 50 mm and thickness of cramps vary from 5 mm to 10 mm. The holes made on the stones should be of dovetail shape as shown in this figure. It prevents the tendency of the joint to be pulled apart. The cramps are placed in position, grouted and covered with cement, lead or asphalt. So here all types of joint in stone masonry are finished. In next video we will discuss about classification of stone masonry. So thanks for watching. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.